Back in the day, you had been part of the smart set. You holidayed with kings, dined out with starlets. From London to New York, Cap Farah to Capri, in perfume by Chanel and clothes by Givenchy. You sipped Camparis with David and Peter at Noel's parties by Lake Geneva, scaling the dizzy heights of high society, armed only with a checkbook and the family tree. You chased the sun around the Côte d'Azur until the light of youth became obscure and left you on your own and in the shade. An English lady of a certain age, and if a nice young man would buy you a drink, you'd say with a conspiratorial wink, you wouldn't think that I was 17. And he'd say, no, you couldn't be. You had to marry someone very, very rich so that you might be kept in the style to which you had all of your life been accustomed to, but that the socialist had taxed the way from you. You gave him children, a girl and a boy, to keep your sanity a nanny was employed, and when the time came they were sent away. Well, that was simply what you did in those days. You chased the sun around the Côte d'Azur until the light of youth became obscure and left you on your own and in the shade. An English lady of a certain age, if a nice young man would buy you a drink, you'd say with a conspiratorial wink, you wouldn't think that I was 63. And he'd say, no, you couldn't be. Your son's in stocks and bonds and lives back in Surrey, lies down once in a while, leaves in a hurry. Your daughter never finished her finishing school, married a strange young man of whom you don't approve. Your husband's hollow heart gave out one Christmas day. He left the villa to his mistress in Marseille, and so you come here to escape your little flat, hoping someone will fill your glass and let you chat about how you chased the sun around the Côte d'Azur until the light of youth became obscured and left you all alone and in the shade. An English lady of a certain age, and if a nice young man would buy you a drink, you'd say with a conspiratorial wink, you wouldn't think that I was 53.